it's Missy. Welcome back to my channel. Today's tutorial is 3 half-up hairstyles. I think these are a little bit different and more unique than your typical half-up hairstyles, so I really hope you enjoy today's video. If you're new to my channel or you haven't subscribed yet, make sure to subscribe so you don't miss out on future videos, and let's get started. For the first hairstyle, I'm going to start by dividing up the top section of hair, keeping some hair down on the sides to cover my ears, and I'm just going to bring this to the back of my head and tie it off with an elastic band. Now I'm going to take this hair and split it into 2 equal sections. Then I'm going to take one of the sections and begin wrapping it around the hair elastic. As you're doing this, you'll want to make sure to wrap the hair kind of tight so it's easier to pin. You can always go back after and make it a little bit bigger if you'd like. So once I've wrapped it about twice around the elastic, I'm going to start pinning the twist against my head. Go ahead and play around with the shape of it so each twisted piece is about the same size, and you'll just want to continue pinning it against the head until it feels nice and tight so that it doesn't come loose. I love the way this style looks because it seems like it'd be a lot more complicated to do than it actually is, but it literally only takes a few seconds to do. For the next style, I'm going to start by sliding 2 bobby pins along the back of my head horizontally, creating a line. These are going to help anchor the hairstyle in place. So then I'm just going to divide off a section of hair on both the left and right side of the head, and I'm going to bring these to the back of my head and tie the 2 pieces into a knot. So I'm going to place the left side over the right, then I'm going to tuck the left strand up and around the right strand, and then pull the 2 sections apart to tighten the hair against my head. This is the first half of the knot. And then so the hair doesn't slip out, I'm going to slide 2 bobby pins into the top part of the knot to help hold it in place. And now I'm going to repeat the same steps again, crossing the left strand over the right, pushing the left strand up and around the right strand to finish off the knot. And then I'm just going to pin it in place again, and the best trick for knowing where to put your bobby pins is to just place them wherever your fingers are holding the hair. And I made sure to tuck them underneath the knot so that they didn't show. Now I'm just going to go back over the hair and pull on different pieces so the knot looks really big and full. It ended up looking kind of like a bow, but I think it's so cute and I really love how this one turned out. For the last hairstyle, I'm going to start by sliding 2 bobby pins along the back of my head again, horizontally to help anchor the hairstyle. Then I'm going to pick up a section on the right side from above my ear, and I'm going to drape this hair towards the back of my head and then slide some bobby pins into the hair to help hold it in place. I slid mine underneath the hair so that you don't see them, and I'm just doing this because I don't want the braid to be too droopy, but I also don't want to use an elastic band either. So then I'm going to do the same thing with the hair on the left side, draping it towards the back of my head and pinning it in place with some bobby pins. And now with my 2 sections of hair, I'm going to twist each section towards the left and then wrap them around each other towards the right. And this is important because twisting them one way while wrapping them in the opposite direction is what will keep the twist from just unraveling. So once the twist reaches the ends of the hair, I'm going to tie it off with a clear elastic band. And now for the fun part, I'm going to gently pull on small pieces of hair in the twist until it's really big and full. You don't want to pull on the entire twist because that will just loosen it up. So make sure to pull along the edges so the hair kind of slides out of the elastic just a little bit. And I love how unique and different this hairstyle turned out. It's definitely not one you see every day. So that wraps up today's tutorial. Be sure to let me know in the comment section which of the 3 hairstyles was your favorite, and if you want to see more tutorials like this one with multiple hairstyles in one video, be sure to click the thumbs up and I will be sure to film some more of them. If you're new to my channel, make sure to subscribe as well, that way you won't miss out on any future videos. Thank you so very much for watching, and I will see you next time.